You are selling every single day of your life. In any conversation, in any interaction, you're selling with your family, you're selling your friends, you're even selling your neighbors and the person at the Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru that you see every single day. In every moment, we're selling. And the better of a salesperson you can be, the stronger you will be in your relationships, your career, your family, and in practically every area of life. And in this video, I want to talk to you about how you can be an even better salesperson. So let's get right to it. Being a great salesperson doesn't begin with selling your product. It doesn't begin with selling your service or trying to influence anybody to do anything. Being a great salesperson starts with selling yourself. That's right. You have to sell yourself every single day of your life on several things. Every time you wake up and you kick your legs out of bed and stand up and get ready for work, or you get ready to go to a presentation, or you get ready to sell or influence anybody, the first thing you have to ask yourself is, why am I doing this? What is my reason for doing the job that I do? What is the reason why I'm going to work every single day? What is the reason why I work with this company? What is the reason why I do what I do and all? Because if you don't have a strong, compelling reason, then what happens when obstacles come your way? What happens when you encounter difficulties and encounter challenges and roadblocks and all these things that will get in the way of your success? You have to sell yourself. You have to ask yourself the question, what is the reason I'm doing this? What is it that I want to achieve? And this is an everyday thing because, believe me, your brain isn't that smart, right? We're animals. We have to sell ourselves every single day. And you can motivate yourself and get into this emotional state in whatever way that works best for you. But what I found works best for most salespeople that I've worked with is to revisit their goals, revisit the reason why they're selling that product or selling that service. Sell yourself on why you're doing what you're doing, because the more certain that you are in what you do, the more able you're going to be to influence anybody. Certainty equals sales. Certainty equals results. You know, salespeople have a bad rep. They are seen as these sleazy, shady individuals who are trying to make a quick buck, who are trying to push their product onto somebody else. Like, as an example, when I ask you, what do you think about when you think of a used car salesman? What adjectives come to mind? Is it happy, positive, looking out for my best interest, looking to help me, looking to serve me? Probably not. When you think of a used car salesman, you're generally getting somebody who's a fast talker. You're getting somebody who is energetic, enthusiastic, who tries to show you what makes them the most money, who might even manipulate you, who might even lie to you. And the reality is, that's the view of salespeople from the scope of everybody in the world who isn't a salesperson. And the reality is, we have to change that perception. Because the best salespeople, the number one way to be a great salesperson is not to be a fast talker at all. It's not to be sleazy at all. You have to do the right thing, and you have to sell with integrity. Integrity is the number one thing when it comes to being a great salesperson. And in order to truly be great, you don't fast talk, because the reality is, the best salespeople only talk 20% of the time. Salespeople are listening to the person they're looking to influence, whether that's a customer or a business owner or even your spouse or even your children. If you want to influence anybody to do anything, you have to listen and use your two ears to hear what they want, to know what their aspirations are, to know what their end result is. And only after you listen for that 80% of the time can you open your mouth and give advice. You have to be able to listen and truly understand what that other person is looking to do before you can offer any solution. You have no idea how many salespeople I've met who don't even know what the customer wants, but they just start pitching and they just start selling the customer what they think the customer wants. But what if instead you didn't assume? What if instead you asked great questions in order to discover what this individual really wants? You know, the 20% that you're talking, that's you asking questions. And after you listen 80%, and you ask questions for the other 20%, only then do you have enough information to be able to offer that person something that will be great for them. Only after you hear out your significant other on what their concerns are, can you now give your opinion or give your own solution. You have to listen to other people, because listening to other people helps them to feel understood, and listening to other people helps to build that trust that you need in any relationship. And even if you're working with a client or a customer one time, that is a relationship. Sales is a relationship game. And the greatest salespeople are not looking for a quick buck. They're not looking to make a simple and fast transaction. Those are the new salespeople. Those are the rookies. Those are the people who don't understand the game. The best salespeople are looking to build a long-term relationship. So remember, to build that relationship, listen 80% of the time and only open your mouth 20% of the time. On this YouTube channel, we talk about a ton of different strategies and techniques when it comes to influence, when it comes to sales, and when it comes to living a better life. So if you're new here, we release videos every Monday through Friday. Hit the subscribe button here and hit the bell. That way you're notified of all new videos. And if these tips have already been helpful for you, help out the channel, hit the like button here, because that will get this video into the hands of more people who could use it. The greatest salespeople truly believe in what it is they're selling. They believe in their product. They believe in their message. They believe in the solution that they're offering to their customer or whoever else you're looking to influence. Now, this is the thing. If you don't believe in your product, if you don't think that you're offering someone a great thing, then you have to stop offering it. Because if you know that something isn't a good option for somebody else, you either need to learn more about that product and see how it can benefit someone else, or you need to find a product or a message that you're more comfortable with offering to other people. Because if you're offering someone something that you're not even fully behind, then that is selling without integrity. And remember the number one word we talked about earlier, you must sell with integrity. And this is the thing, sometimes you might even be selling a product that it's kind of tough to be passionate about. Like for many, many years, I sold cell phones. And it's kind of hard to be like, oh my God, I absolutely love cell phones. Like maybe at the beginning it's cool because the new cell phone comes out and it's got the big screen, it's got the nice camera. But after you do it for 5 years, 6 years, even like a couple years, they all become the same. A phone becomes a phone, and every phone does the same things. So you have to ask yourself, how can I get passionate about this product or service that I've been selling for years and that I've become used to and become accustomed to? The number one way is, instead of being passionate about the product, be passionate about the person you're looking to help. Be passionate about who it is you're looking to influence. I started to think instead, well, if I'm not passionate about the cell phone itself, what does this cell phone help people to do? How does it benefit other people's lives? And obviously the answer is, the cell phone allows people to connect with their family from anywhere in the world. It allows them to FaceTime with their grandmother who they seldom see. It allows them to talk to people, even if they are, like I just said, across the world. It allows people to stay in touch and to continue to build relationships. It allows people to do business right from their email. It allows people to post on social media. It allows people to take pictures and save memories of things that they might never experience again. Cell phones are great. But what's even more great is what it's going to do for the other person. So ask yourself, this message that I'm trying to convey to somebody, this product that I'm looking to sell, how does it help the person? And when you're selling your product, don't talk about how great the product is. Talk about what that product will specifically do for this human being across from you. If you're trying to influence your kids to go eat their vegetables, rather than say, eat the vegetables, they taste good, your kids don't think that. Instead, you should say, hey, you should go eat those vegetables because it's gonna make you strong, it's gonna make you healthy, and you might even throw a little reward in there at the end. If you eat your vegetables every night this week, we'll go out for ice cream this weekend. And they're gonna be like, oh yeah, that sounds great, and they're gonna go eat their vegetables. Maybe, right? If they don't, then you just might have to become an even greater salesperson. But be passionate and be able to back what it is you're offering and selling to other people. And if you can't get passionate about it, find something else that you can get passionate about. Or ask yourself, how does this help the person on the other side of the desk from me? If you found these tips helpful, I want you to watch this video next, which is all about how to influence people in the digital age, which goes further into these tips and strategies. And until we talk again next time, continue to be better.